Gene editing is a very powerful methodology that became feasible only a few years ago. Historically, when we have, as a society, dealt with disease, we have treated an individual patient or a group of people. We've developed protective methods, prophylactic methods, vaccines. We've developed drugs that can stop the course of a disease and return people to health. But we've never done anything that will change the genes of the human race. And we've never done anything that will have effects that will go on through the generations. Revolution that was started by the discovery of CRISPR-Cas9, which is a simple way of doing gene replacement that was never available to us before. That revolution is playing itself out now over time, will be playing itself out. And we're hoping that these series of meetings will provide guidance, provide a form of interaction between the scientific community and the general public. We don't have an international body that has any authority to dictate what's done in laboratories anywhere in the world. And so we have to come together to agree on what we want to do and how we want to do it and what we consider to be right and wrong on a voluntary basis, effectively. We wanted meetings of this sort to engage people from all over the world. Part of our hope is that the advances of science will be available to the whole world.